So today we want to show you a day in our life, how I work a regular 9-to-5 job remote, how we get internet, how we get power, how I am in Zoom meetings all day long. I'm usually up and out of bed a little bit earlier than Nate to start my day. I make coffee and then I sit over here on my computer until I'm ready to start work, which sometimes is like 30 minutes or an hour before I can get up the energy to start my day. My favorite thing about this cabin is the big windows and the beautiful views. One of the first things I do every morning is check where we are at the power. Right now we're at a cool 23% power, so I will not be plugging in my second monitor until much later in the morning if it starts to get a bit sunnier out. We also have the option of turning on the generator for a while if it gets very low.
I tend to do the same thing in the mornings where I just try to work on the laptop battery. Shannon does the same thing where we'll just charge them up fully during the day before. And then that way in the mornings, we can just work on the batteries without having to plug into the Bluetti for the first few hours, at least until the sun gets higher in the sky. And then we actually have full solar today. Like Shannon said, it is pretty cloudy. So there's a good chance we're gonna need to fire up the generator at some point.
Yeah, their ears are like a foot tall. They're so cute. Kind of scary.
They're huge. Like
they can eat me.
Look at this. It looks
like deer. Recently picked up this sit stand desk from Amazon and I am in love with it. I think I'm gonna be able to bring it into the tiny house when we finish that. It was the only one that I could find. It's a little shelf on the inside and it rolls around. It's awesome.
Well, doesn't look like we're gonna have to turn on the generator this morning. There's not a cloud in the sky. It's cleared up nicely. It's pretty rare that we fire that generator up. Once the sun gets high in the sky, even on relatively cloudy days, our 600 watts of solar is more than enough to provide what we need, and it's looking like today is gonna be a beautiful day.
Not really a breakfast person, but I usually get hungry around 11. I think a lot of people can agree that the best part of working remote now is being able to make food anytime you want. So I usually have a snack around 11. So my job now is like 50% meetings. It didn't used to be like that, but now more than ever, consistent cell coverage is really important to my job. You know, I can't just be on a meeting and then cut out in the middle of talking to a client. So we've come up with a couple of solutions that have been working really well for us. The best one being this unlimited T-Mobile hotspot that Nate recently picked up.
Yeah, so we do have a cell booster out here. I know a lot of folks have asked about that. It's a high boost cell booster that Shannon bought a couple of months before we came out here, sort of in anticipation, I guess, of being in the middle of nowhere like this. And, you know, Shannon has AT&T on her iPhone. She's had that since we were on the road, and she uses her hotspot there, you know, turns on the hotspot option, and then I have my Android phone on Verizon and did the same thing with the hotspot. Out here, we sort of realized, though, that AT&T and Verizon actually have worse coverage than T-Mobile. We took a shot in the dark. I picked up this T-Mobile hotspot. I got a SIM card to test it out, and it's way faster than both of them out here for some reason, and I guess maybe because they merged with Sprint or whatever it is, but I ended up picking up an unlimited T-Mobile hotspot. It's actually like a little jetpack kind of thing. I got it through the Calyx Foundation. I'll put a link in the description below, and it is completely unthrottled, unlimited internet. We've used like 60 gigabytes this month, and it's not even the end of the month yet. it's working really well in combination with the hotspot on AT&T and the hotspot on Verizon and the cell booster. And
we are also on the wait list for Starlink. I signed up for it back in January when we first knew that we were coming out here. And I actually just recently saw on the local Facebook group that some people right down the road have already gotten their kits and installed them and says that it works great. So hopefully we'll be getting ours really soon.
It's only a matter of time before we've got Starlink and then all three major cell carriers out here.
You want my coffee?
Ooh, thank you.
Yep. Go to a meeting now. 1 minute.
Oh, that's really good.
Meetings.
It's been a long day.
Did you see that it rained like 4 drops?
Yeah, I went outside.
You were preparing everything for rain. It just skipped right over us. Well, what are we having for dinner?
We ran out of propane.
Oh, really? So what should we eat?
Going to the village.
We're going to the village? Date night?
Yeah.
Right. And now is the hour or so of me pretending like I'm done with work, and then I keep wandering back over to my computer and sending the occasional email that I realize I forgot to send during the day. But we don't have time for that today. We're going to dinner.
I spoke too soon this morning. I did a lot of editing today, and it was very, very cloudy for most of the afternoon. Shannon had her monitor running as well. We were really like maxing out the amount of power that we needed. So I got to fire up the generator just for like an hour or so to top off the Blue Yeti, and I'm gonna render a couple of videos while it's running just to get the most out of our time burning gasoline. I guess not. Every day is just like this. I mean, this one we were kind of just here all day. We were able to just hang out in the cabin. Some days we have to go into town and do a bunch of errands, and on those days, gotta do some planning, you know?
I'd say the majority of the days we spend here, but like once or twice a week, we do have to go into town, which is from here about 50 minutes to an hour. So when we go in, it's like an all day event. You know, I have to plan into my schedule when we're going to drive up there in the morning. I have to block off periods of my schedule so I don't get a meeting scheduled, you know, the night before we're planning to go up there. And then once we're up there, like we're there for the whole day. And what we found recently is because I'm in a lot more meetings, the location of where we end up to work is a lot more important. I found that Starbucks's recently have just been way too loud for meetings. So I end up doing a lot of meetings in the car. There are a couple coffee shops that are really good for working, but it's not always guaranteed. So it does take kind of a lot of planning to make sure that I have a place to work for the day in town.
It actually does relate kind of pretty well to what it was like for us on the road when we were traveling in the High Ace, and then even in your Sprinter and my NV200 back then. You know, we had to kind of plan things. And especially now that Shannon has more meetings these days than she used to, you know, if we were, for example, traveling on a weekend, on a Saturday or a Sunday, we would need to drive quite a bit so that we were set up and ready for the week ahead. We wanted to make sure that if we were going to be camping somewhere, boondocking, that we were going to have full cell coverage. And the only way to make sure of that was to take that extra time on the weekends to plan it out.
Yeah. And I used to be able to work a lot more just kind of wherever, but now that I have all these meetings, like I'm just talking so much more, and so I have to have really good cell coverage, and it has to be quiet enough where people can actually hear me. So it just definitely added another layer of challenge to our work remote setup.
I'd say it's good practice though, right now, you know, because eventually we will be back on the road in our future truck camper. Won't be for a while, but you know, when we get to that point, we'll be ready to work remotely. I'm gonna end this video here, guys. I hope this one was helpful for some of y'all that are maybe considering trying to work remotely, a regular job while living off-grid, or any job. These are just some of the things that we have done over the past so many years and will continue to do into the future. We've got a couple of fun adventures planned, a couple of surprises over the next few days. I'm really, really excited about it. A few things I'm gonna be working on and doing a couple of videos, so look forward to sharing those with you guys, and can't thank y'all enough for watching, for following along. I'll talk to y'all in the next one.